Hey guys, it's Rachel, and today I want to do a review on the Wet n Wild Coverall Cream Foundation. And before I get into the details of the foundation, I'm just going to show you guys a quick clip of me applying it just so you can see the product in action. The nitty gritty of this product. The Wet n Wild Coverall Cream Foundation comes in a little squeeze tube like this with 1 fluid ounce like most liquid foundations have. And this is what the tip looks like in case you were curious. And I picked mine up for around, I think, $2 or $3 at my local Rite Aid because Wet n Wild was on sale. But usually this is around, I think, $4. It's definitely under $5, so around $4 something, which is extremely affordable. And if you get it on sale, it's even cheaper, which is really great. And I have it in the shade 820 medium tan. Now, the shade range is really limited. For me, I really like this shade because this shade, 820 medium tan, definitely matches an NC30. It has a warm kind of olive undertone to it, and it matches my skin perfectly. Like, I've never found a perfect match for myself personally, so I really, really like the color of this foundation. However, there's only like 7 shades, I think, max in the shade range, so there isn't that many options, and it's only 1 shade darker than this foundation, and they're like 5 shades lighter. So if you're more of a fair skin tone, you will be able to probably find a shade that will match you. But if you're darker than me, which I feel like a lot of people are, it's really hard to find a shade. There's only 1 shade darker than this, 858, I believe, and it's like 5 shades darker than this foundation. So there's like a huge jump in the shade range, and it doesn't really cater towards a lot of darker skin tones. So that's a downside if you are of more darker complexion. But if you're a lighter skin tone, you will definitely find a shade for you because there's a lot of different lighter shades. Now onto the claims of this foundation. It claims to have all day wear, medium to full coverage, a lightweight satin matte finish, and it claims to have a Visibrite complex that reduces the appearance of wrinkles and rejuvenates the skin. As for the Visibrite complex, I don't really notice anything. I've only been wearing it for like 2 weeks, I think. So of course I'm not going to see results right away. I really doubt it does anything for your skin, but I mean, it's good to know there's something in it, I guess. And okay, so as for the other claims, the all day wear, I definitely agree with. I have very, 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 very oily skin. I break out into oil usually like 3 hours after I apply foundation. So I'm very oily skinned, and this foundation I can wear for around 4 to 5 hours before I need to blot or powder my face. So it definitely stays matte and holds up on your face really well. And as for the coverage, as you can see in the demo I showed you guys, it gives really, really nice medium to full coverage. One layer of foundation covers up most of my dark spots, and as you can see, I have a lot of dark spots. So one layer covers all my dark spots, and then I just apply a second layer kind of around this area because I have a lot of dark pigmentation right here. So I apply a second layer there to get full coverage on that area, and I don't even need to apply concealer afterwards, only under my eyes because they don't cover dark circles. And as for the lightweight and satin matte finish, I definitely feel like it's lightweight on the skin. I don't feel it's really heavy like the Revlon Whipped Cream Foundation or whatever. I know that one is pretty heavy on the skin, and so is Revlon Colorstay. This one definitely feels lighter than it, and it doesn't have a really painted on cakey effect. It definitely has a more satin matte finish as it describes, because it's not super flat like the CoverGirl 3-in-1, but it's not really dewy either. So out of all the high coverage, full coverage foundations I have tried, this one definitely looks the most natural out of all of them. Like my Revlon and CoverGirl can look kind of cakey if I don't apply it very carefully, but this one doesn't look as cakey or like you painted your face. It obviously looks like you're wearing makeup because it is a full coverage foundation, but it doesn't look like you just painted your face and caked on a lot of makeup. It looks like just like a thin layer of foundation on your skin and doesn't look bad at all. And I don't know if there's an SPF on it. I swear I saw a review saying it had SPF, but it doesn't say it on my tube. So I believe this would be fine for flash photography. So overall, I love this foundation to death. It might be my new holy grail. And if you can find your shade, I definitely recommend trying it out, because I feel like the only thing that is lacking about this foundation is its shade range, because it's super affordable, has nice coverage and finish and wear time, but the shade range is a downer. So if you can find your shade, I definitely recommend trying it, but if you can't, oh, I'm sorry. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this review and found it helpful, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.